Hi, Derek, and other viewers of this video response to a video on the channel called Veritasium. It's about time I did something outside the sorts of weird science-y stuff usually posted on my channel. So, five fun physics phenomena, you say? How do they work? Let's start with the first one. When balancing a cane, or hockey stick, on two fingers and moving them together, your fingers always meet at the center of mass, leaving the stick balanced. When your fingers are apart, statics dictate that the normal force from the finger closer to the center of mass is greater than that of the other. And because the surfaces of the stick and finger are pressing harder on each other here, there is more friction. So when you move your fingers together, the force of friction from the closer finger overtakes that of the other, so the stick always moves towards the finger which is further from its center of mass. Of course, if it moves too close to it, the first finger is now the further one, and it will now start moving toward it. The center of mass is always constrained between the fingers, so it will always be right above them when they meet. Number 2. You can flip a phone like this, and like this, pretty easily, but it wobbles about when you flip it this way. Maybe the phone's center of mass is not directly in its center, so let's try spinning a block of wood instead, which should have a more or less even distribution of mass. And the same thing still happens. It can't be about how balanced you throw it, because it still happens when you throw it with one hand. It must be air resistance. That's why spinning it like this is easy. The air can't do much because it isn't hitting much surface area. But why should spinning it about its length be stable too? There's more air resistance here. First, we need to realize that it is easier to spin the block lengthwise rather than widthwise, because it has a lower moment of inertia, requiring less torque to spin it. When spinning widthwise, the air pushes against the board further from its center of mass, giving it a mechanical advantage. If there is ever a slight imbalance in air resistance for a split second, the air will try to get the block spinning lengthwise, which is the easier way to spin it, so it succeeds. Meanwhile, when already spinning lengthwise, the air no longer has as much of a mechanical advantage, and it would also need to work even harder to make the block start spinning widthwise anyway, so it does not succeed. I'll admit that I'm a bit unsure about this explanation. I really wish I had a vacuum chamber right now. Number 3. Static electricity. Rub a plastic cup or balloon in your hair, and it attracts stuff. Pieces of paper, a stream of water, and even a stream of oil. It doesn't need to be a polar molecule. Assuming the balloon has a negative charge, when you move it close to any of these things, the balloon repels the negative charges in that medium. This leaves the side closer to the balloon with a net positive charge, so the positive edge is attracted to the negative balloon. Number 4. You can pull on a piece of cereal with a magnet. We know that the magnetic domains of iron will align with an external magnetic field. This happens in such a way that it and the magnet attract each other. The cereal has lots of iron in it, so it gets attracted to the magnet too. Number 5. A teabag lit on fire will shoot up in the air just before it burns out. This reminds me of the little bits of ash that fly into the air in a campfire. The fire makes things hot. So, hot and therefore less dense air will rise. Now, some cooler air from elsewhere needs to take its place. This leads to a convection current, which the teabag follows when it gets light enough for the moving air to influence it. So to recap, the cane's center of mass stays in between your fingers because friction always makes it approach the finger which is further. The air will make the phone or block of wood go crazy if it can generate enough torque for a split second of random uneven air resistance. This depends on the total surface the air hits, the mechanical advantage it has, and specifically which direction it's trying to make the phone spin. The water and everything else is attracted to a charged cup and balloon because negative charges in the water are mobile, so the side closer to the cup or balloon becomes the opposite charge and attracts. The iron in the cereal is exposed to a magnetic field and becomes a magnet in the same direction, so it attracts. The teabag launches into the air because the heat from the fire caused the surrounding air to blow the teabag upward. There, that's my take on it. Hope you enjoyed. Did I overlook anything? I look forward to the solution video.